Following video is rated M for strong language and idiotic mistakes. May contain spoilers with attitude. You have been warned.
Hey guys, James here, aka Wade McGinnis, and this is Gaming Theater. I know I've been gone for a while, now I'm back! And it is time to get into some gaming, some good old-fashioned gaming. Starting with Darkwood. Now this is a indie game that was actually kickstarted on Indiegogo, and I know this for a fact because I was one of the backers. It's from Acid Wizards. You can get this right now on Steam Early Access for I think $14.99. I think that's actually the current price tag for the game. And I can tell you right now, if you're into survival horror, top-down roguelike style games with a lot of like awesome randomly generated stuff and some really good fashion scares, this is the game for you, my friends. This is the game for you. Again, though, this is still in alpha. This is still in Steam Early Access. So anything that, if it goes haywire, batshit crazy, or happens to change down the road, it's always evolving, it's always improving, it's always getting better. I've been keeping a very keen eye. I've been playing a lot of over 22 hours into this game, and I finally am doing an episode on it. Gaming Theater episode on it. So as you can tell, I love this game. I love this game. Love it. Love it. So real quick, options are very, very absolutely minor. I mean, you can't get any more minor than that. All right, let's go into new play. Permadeath is off. I don't want to skip the prologue. Spooky music. Even when I'm asleep, I can't stop seeing their faces. Looking at me with trust. Like I could heal them, save them from spreading the plague. Whatever the plague is. Like I could stop the process which destroys their land, rots their bodies and minds. There's no way out of here. I'm stuck with them. They claw, they scratch. Disgusting things, the humans. With our unending calling, pleading cries, and muttered prayers.
Ooh, spooky.
Alright, so if you remember how. Of course, I played 22 hours of the game, but you know, it's been a little while. I took like 2.5 month break. A homemade device for making moonshine. I'm too far away. I know these notes by heart. I don't want to read them now. Well, screw you. Take some drogas. Some pills. Let's grab the chair. Cages, this time they're empty. Huh. Rather not open it, but I spent too much time. Just to sort some stuff here, but jammed long ago. There's been a radio sounds for years, although sometimes I can hear voices among the noises. Can I play with it? This is actually new. This little radio part is actually pretty new. Okay, can I? No, I don't. Damn it! I just want to shut it off. I don't want to. Alright, got the key to the front door. Ew! Now, if I wanted to, this is kind of cool. I can shut it off, or, there we go, I could drag it into the other room, but for right now, I'm actually gonna not do that, because, you know, that's a bad, it's not a good idea. Now, if you notice, there's a barricade option. I could totally barricade it, don't want to, yeah, but I could if I wanted to. Poor little pup. My dog. I don't think he's gonna make it. I should end his suffering. See if I remember, it's I, isn't it? It's tab. Yeah, it's tab. Plink. I don't think I picked up a weapon. Medical bag. Tribuna Luda. I can't read any of that. Like, that's not even English for me. There's actually more things to, like, look around and discover. I realize there's a dog there. I realize the doggy's in pain. Don't worry. When I first played this, there's a gaming theater episode that's actually... Or not a gaming theater episode, excuse me. Of an outplaying series for the game. And I had it going for a little while. And I'll be honest with you guys, like... When I came across the dog, I didn't think you could actually put the dog out of his misery, and I'm a little kind of affected by that, and I'm going to go do that right now. I mean, look at that, he's bleeding out, and it's a gut wound, it's horrible, let's do this, be humane about it, at least. I'm sorry, pup. Still don't like that. Really don't like that. I mean, I'm glad that it's there. It gives you a very good idea of the type of game we're going to play. Admittedly, this is a game that I feel like doesn't hold its punch. It won't. It really won't. Which is great. But at the very same time, you just... I love animals, okay? And that's just affecting, really. Hey, open squirrels. I don't know if you guys noticed, but, like, when you go to check your inventory, you may see very little up until that last point, in which case you're like, I'm screwed. Can't see anything. Alright, I wonder if, man, I forgot how crafting works in the game. 22 hours in, and I forgot. Spice of the woods, a duck. Should craft a torch. Hit the tab. There we go, that's how that's actually done. Man, I'm glad I'm intelligent. Now, if I remember correctly, though, you have to make a choice between having a torch and having a weapon. Which is also pretty awesome. If I could... where am I going? I'm going north. North. Now, over the course of your gameplay experience, you will come across the situation of NPCs that are slightly out of their mental... state, like, they're slightly insane. A little bit, not a lot, a little bit. I was gonna come across the option to upgrade your character. Oh yeah, that's a good tree. In a few days, it will be completely absorbed. See, here's like what you... I'm looking at this going, alright, you know, we got a situation where, we are really in a really bad area. Like, like this is insanely bad. I think this is purgatory. I feel like that might be it. And now, I think this one's still alive. Damn it! Big metal key. He's unconscious. Little rat didn't make it to his hole. If he's got the key, he must know where the door is. Only pests like him know how to get out of these woods. Of course, he won't willingly tell me anything. But this, however... doesn't really matter. Shit's gotten dark. And now you see who you are. Alright, so remember, I have, for like the longest time, I was completely fucking confused. Like, I'm like, I don't know how to do, I'm stuck in a room, I don't know what's going on. I'm botching shit. Shit's getting botched. Alright, we need some bandages. Make a pick lock. Pick it a pick. Pick it a pick, pick, pick. I unlocked it. Booyah. Okay, and then we're gonna go ahead and. There we go. Put that there, put that there. And this is gonna break almost instantly. Okay, so. Almost instantly happens to be just slightly less ominous. Oh. Yeah, the candles are new. Oh, fuck. This is a horror game. So, I should. Man, I'm gonna have a warning at the beginning of the game. Gaming theater episode. I'm gonna see if I can. Like, warning! May I scream? In a high pitched squeal. Shut the fuck. Shut it. Yeah, okay, shut that off. Don't. We don't want that. That's bad. Woo! It's got shit in it. Okay, come on. Yes! Okay. Just kinda. Oh, hey, it's a body. Hey, Jenny. The generators turn off, yet I can hear a faint metallic sound of the engine. I don't want to turn it on just yet. The figure in the bed is wearing a worn coat and a weathered hat. His eyes are fixed on the hilt of a scalpel stuck in his forehead. Warm wax drips from the wound onto the metal surface. I don't recognize his face, but I know who he is. There's something fucking outside, and I know this, and I don't like that I know this. I know this. Simple weapon. I'm gonna craft a simple weapon. Cause, shit, why the hell not? I have a simple weapon. I feel slightly more better about this. Okay, so we gotta refill the Jenny. Man, I could have sworn I heard somebody come through the door. Wait. I heard somebody go through the door. Somebody here? Hello? Hello? Somebody? No, it's barricaded. Who's there? Please let me out. You're out. You're a fucking liar, though, aren't you? Mm-hmm. No! Yeah! Suck it!
You never got a win.
Hee-hee. No, hee-hee. No, hee-hee! No. Jenny, protect me. Grab the light. No! Fuck the light. Huh? You wanna go? Wanna go? And shine, says the wolfy wolf. I can feel your stench from afar. You should be thankful I don't have an appetite for carcasses, Sam. I'm not dead, buddy boy. I don't think I'm dead. Am I dead? He hides his face under a hood. I can feel the smell of wet ground and fur. I came after your reek to inform you. Your reek? Came after your reek to inform you about something, but looking at your face, someone has already done just that. These woods are full of little trinkets, treasures. If you find anything valuable, I'll gladly have a look at it. maybe even give you something in exchange. Now, here's the thing. You can kill this guy. Okay, you can kill him at the beginning. Don't. As far as I can tell, don't. It's a possibility. Don't. Unless you want hard mode, don't. My hideout is the northwestern pot to the meadow. Remember this because the likes of you always come back to me. I almost forgot. A little welcome present. With this unusual bucket, you will be able to drink our local crystal clear water straight from the well. You'll see, when the night comes, you won't be able to live without it. Okay, let's gossip. Taking a stroll through the woods after dusk means certain death meat. Better find some walls to hide behind before nightfall and pray for the morning light. Oh, what a beautiful thing this is, mate. I know to whom it belonged to. Wolf giggles as he looks at the dog tag. Giggy. You'd like to know too, eh? It's funny that someone would like to speak so much, would never say a word. I'll give you a piece of advice, almost for free. If you want to know more about where this thing came from, find the woman who stinks of chickens, eh? You'll find her in a cottage in the northwestern part of the forest. It takes a step in my direction. If you find anything worthwhile from her, do remember that I like information. It would be wise to live in good terms with me, Comrade Meat.
Comrade Meat. Okay.
Alright, let's bust through the door here, look around. Mushrooms are always good. Just don't run over them. They explode and they hurt, and admittedly, you can't take the damage. Buckets! More than one bucket. Awesome. That means that if I come across another area, I can actually, well, survive. You actually, no joke, you seriously need, and I'm not joking, you absolutely need buckets in this game. The water allows you to basically stop your health from just draining absolutely. When nighttime comes, the wells actually turn red, signaling that you need to go drink them, and then at that point, you know, for God's sakes, get in a hole and just cower. A little pro tip that I found out that I personally, you know, like to use, and yeah, maybe you probably are noticing this, is using your vision to focus in what's in front of you. Because again, stepping on a mushroom, stepping on like a bear trap. It's called a bad day, guys. It's a fucking bad day. It's actually just trees that block my path. And dense trees. Really dense trees, that's new. Again, haven't played like 2 months, so they've obviously patched a few things in. Because I think the last time I played, patch was like 1-1. Like, literally. You don't get any fresh than that. The other thing is, remember to access your map and start encountering like landmarks. It'll make navigating your randomly generated terrain that much easier. So every time you die and start a new game, I should say, you gotta deal with new goodies. Hey, woof woof. Yeah, I don't have the codes. Hey, that's new. What is it? There's a rabbit! Holy shit! I think that might be. I can't remember if that's new. Rabbits to the game might be new. I don't know yet. It's also new. It's a little more craggy than I was expecting. Before it was just like an open map. That's actually with goodies and stuff. Which is good, I guess, you know. Hello. Can I not interact? The car is not interactable, huh? There's nothing in the car? Really? And mushrooms, take those.
Flare's pretty good, you know, admittedly. Not much for anything else, you know, other than just being a flare, but, you know, it's not like it's gonna deter things, it's just gonna, you know, be there. Let's see, can I vault over this? Ah, they still won't let me vault over that, huh? Okay, so I need to be able to get the key to go through that, or I might be able to break the door down. Just depends on what I'm willing to do. At this point, I'm more willing to get a key. So far, no enemies, no dogs, no rabbit dogs, no creepy, weird natives. They exist, just so you know. Broken tree. With... Oh, shrine. Sweet. I got... What is that? A what? Oh, I gotta get a saw. That's new. I can... Huh, really? Alright. See, what I love is, you know, like some bandages. And God, I don't have to worry about really food too much. At least not yet in the alpha. I mean, food if I want to level. Yeah, totally, totally. But, other than that, really, you don't have to worry about food or water. The well. Which is... Where am I? The hell am I? Like, apparently I found something called the well. Is it over here? Man, it sucks. I don't have a saw to cut said logs and turn them into planks, and then take planks and turn them into good old-fashioned, I don't know, like, good old-fashioned, how to put it, weapons. There we go. It's strange. It's like a burial. Or sacrificial environment? A ritual circle? It's getting a little panicky because I haven't found any enemies. And normally by this point, I come across tons of enemies. They're just horrible, horrible enemies. Violently horrible. Did they change it? Like, maybe the first night you... Ooh, bear trap. Maybe the first night you don't actually encounter anything? Nope, never mind, never mind. You do, you do, you do. Oh god, you do! Oh god! Oh! Bad doggy! What is this? It's another camp. Jesus Christ. I need a saw. Okay, it's actually getting darker out. Oh boy. Another thing, I think rabbits have been in the game. I do like the way the grass, like, moves with the wind. Very therapeutic considering the environment I'm in. Hey, look, I must return. I'm returning to my hideout. Damn it, I don't have access. Holy shit. Are you serious? Alright. Yeah, look at this. Switch this bad boy on. Yeah! go. I like that a lot. That's awesome. Oh, shit. There we go. Alright. Let's see, what's easier to defend? Oh, I know what it is. Alright, here we go. Like, looking at this going, alright, man, if I had to defend something, what's the better to defend? That would be this right here. Just gonna go ahead and barricade a little bit. Gonna take a look at what I have available. I'm hoping that I have enough in case I need to... Do I need to... Bandage with alcohol. Molotov cocktail. Broken glass. Works both as, I think, a damaging... I think it does actually damage anything that steps on it. And then, of course, it signals to where they're located. Molotov in a different way, which is kind of cool. I like that. Like, you can have two different types of torches. Again, I like that. That's actually really kind of cool. Oh, shit. Alright, so the upper left-hand corner, if you see, to survive, I need to drink the water from the well. Drink the water from the well, boy. Now, for fuck's sake, get in there. Grab your weapon, and then just watch that door. So this is when the fun begins, because what's outside can get really, really dangerous. And also fucking scary. This game gets also very, very dark, and when you start hearing things around you, it gets nerve-wracking. Insanely nerve-wracking. The best part? Monsters attack wild dogs. Wild dogs attack natives. Monsters attack everything. Everything attacks everything. So if you are gutsy enough to walk outside, you can probably loot some of their corpses, because come daytime, everything's gone. At least when I checked when I was playing last time. Downside is you've got to step outside, and if you stepped out at the wrong time, something that might be something you can't kill, but the other, like, six dogs can. Yeah, it's risk-reward thing. Risk-reward. As far as I also noticed, the less movement you make, the less attention you draw to yourself. Like, the dogs are sniffing you out, the monsters are sniffing you out, I think the natives are sniffing you out, I think everybody's sniffing you out. Like, they're trying to figure out where you're at. But here, the less you move, the less you do, if you get yourself in a good spot, you're fine. To the most part. Increases your chances of them not breaking in, destroying your hard-earned work. Alright, starting to get a little bit lighter. I'm hoping daylight's gonna pop up here. The longest I've ever survived in this series was, like, I don't know, 9 days? At that point, the monsters were so terrifying at night that they break through every single damn door, every barricade, every window, and then, like, the last barricade, I'd just be huddling and screaming. For whatever reason, when I first played this, like, by the time you get past day 3, the monsters just start to escalate in difficulty. And I don't know if the game's assuming that you've gotten better at figuring out where the supplies are and where you need to grab them, where all the little secret things are, like getting the sawed-off shotgun, so like in a secret little area. I don't know if the game thinks it's that. Like, I don't know, but I get screwed easily sometimes. Alright, first day is good.
Day one.
Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna dismantle this. Actually, gonna stop. Oh, I can't stop it! That's okay. Anything little surprises out here? Nothing? Alright, just got boom right there at the door. Now, for whatever reason, and I can't really describe it. I'll be honest, I can't really describe it. It's like, it's a weird growth that will basically show up on the ground. I think you can burn it off. But it's a weird little growth that starts to spread in any of your hideouts if you're there long enough. Not too sure what it is, but it will damage you if you touch it. But again, I'm not too sure, like, why it's there. Like, how it should be there and that sort of thing. Whoa. Woo! Hey, buddies!
Hey, puppies!
Alright, pups. Pups, I'm just gonna... Alright. Okay. I wanna antagonize one. But they're doing the pack thing. And they're seriously doing this pack thing, and I don't like this. Like, alright, come here. Come here! Come here! Okay. Come here! Come on! Come on! That last one, here we go. Getting insanely lucky, by the way. Okay. Do not assume that just because that was easy, the dogs are actually easy. And that did it really have? Did you have nothing? Did you have nothing, my friend? Barely had anything worth doing that for. Shit. All right. Well, you know, I don't know. You live, you learn. I thought the cow was gonna have something. I don't know why I really believe that, but you know. It looked like the cow might have something. Hello. I'd like to get a bear trap intact, but I keep screwing it up and junking them. Yep, keep screwing that up. I mean, it's better to have them up now than just run in the middle of the night and just somehow get a bear trap caught on my leg. I can't make a torch. And that's the sort of mushroom you... Oh, yeah. See, that's the sort of mushroom you want to be very careful about. You step on that, it works as an explosion. Good thing is I could take that, basically upgrade myself, getting a trait, and then the next upgrade I think I have to take a negative plus a positive trait. So there's the other thing, is for every positive trait you take after like the first one, you have to take a negative trait, I think. It's kind of an interesting idea if you think about it though. This is a very dark, dark wood. I feel like I'm in purgatory. Alright, is this... Oh my god, what is this? I'm stuck. What is this? Is this like wheat? Is this a weed farm? Oh my god, is this a weed farm? Is there a reason for this? Oh, maybe there is. If it's literally to get to that tractor, I'm so doing this. That tractor might have something awesome. Whoa, what is that? What is that? Wait, what? Whoa. The fuck was that? Okay, hold up. Just, you know, carefully make my way back out of here. I think a monster's in the weed field. I don't know what this is. Are these weeds? All I know is I want to get out of here right now. Like, right now. These things can kill me instantly, as far as I can tell. Let's just get out of here. Ishkidiaddle. This gets sort of kind of getting darker. Okay. I got a handgun clip. Kind of need a pistol, though. I mean, at least I have it. Again, need a pistol. I've only encountered the gun once, and I think that was an accident. Yeah, that was actually an accident. It's like a big boo-boo. Pretty big boo-boo, actually. Ah! Oh, God. Yeah, so... That's why that sucks. Okay. Sorry, guys. That's, really startled me there. Really don't want to die now. Oh, come on! Bad doggies! You don't pick a guy when he's down. You lift him up! Was it here? Supposed to be here? Was that a random noise? Okay. Well, the good thing is my heart rate's up. You know, hey, that's a plus! It's not like I wanted to piss myself. Ooh, 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 yeah. Cottage. Jenny. Ooh, shit. I must return to my hideout before nightfall. Hang on, I'm just... Is there anything in here? It's a dead body. Woo! Oh god! Cottage, keep running, buddy. Just... Or not. Yeah, he's gonna be winded. I would be running for my life. I wouldn't be like... This is why... This is probably exactly why killers tend to catch people who run in horror movies. Because the killers have cardio. My dude doesn't have cardio. Oh, come on, pup! Oh, come on, who did I piss off? Hey, come on. Alright, you're just... Oh god, why are you so slow? Swear to god, why are you so slow, bro? It's getting dark. It's getting dark. It's getting too dark. Don't like this. Okay, there's my house. That's my house. Alright, get in your fucking house. Just go, bro. Go. Okay, shut the damn door. Alright, took a few mushrooms. Cool. Save just a little bit. Awesome, awesome. Alright, gonna take one more. Should put me right over. Can't stay in the dark during the night for too long. See better? Yeah, let's do that. Aw, shit. Actually, let's do more space. Okay, so it's darker. I like that. Okay, and we're gonna go ahead and... do that. I don't wanna do that. Alright, hang. Oh god, I need wood! Give me wood! That's indeed exactly what she said. Barricade! See that? I'm losing health. Slightly. Touch it. Yeah, health. And I received a mushroom. And I'm gonna hide in my corner. Cause you know what? Why the hell not? And we'll see if we survive night two. Be a hell of a way to end a freaking gaming theater episode. Be like, haha! I can't survive. Fuck. Maybe listen. You're gonna hear something out there. It's not just a puppy. And the puppy's not gonna like that. See? Not just a puppy! I don't even know what that is. I don't know. Like, he's all like that. The fuck is that? I see things. I'm seeing shit. Whoa! Whoa! Oh, come on! Oh god, what the hell is going on? And I died. And day three, I wake up in a meadow. Son of a bitch. Alright, guys. Like I said, this is Bane Darkwood. You can get it on Steam Early Access right now. If you like what you see, it's a top-down horror survival game. It's entirely independent and funded by you, the gamer. Alright guys, as always, catch you next time. Hey guys, make sure you check out the videos below for more happy fun times. And if you already haven't, hit that subscriber button to let you know when more happy moments are coming to you on my channel. And finally, if you haven't, hit the like button. Gives you chocolate. No, I'm actually lying. Wish I could give you chocolate. Chocolate.